Okay, so we're going to start with one of the absolute first sweeps I learned from De La Riva Guard. It is super effective, and I still use it now. We are going to start with a good De La Riva hook. So most important thing, I don't want my foot behind his knee. I want to try to get my knee to his knee and my foot up as high as I can. The quality of the hook is really important. If I stay like this and Kai either pushes or just rotates his knee, my hook is coming right out. But if I put this inside, even without the ankle grip, can you try to rotate your knee out? One, that doesn't move. Two, he's not turning it, okay? So that's really important. I'm gonna hold his ankle or his pants. It doesn't matter for the sweep because we're gonna sit up and exchange the grip in a minute anyhow. And then this leg can either be up on his shoulder, like I was playing collar sleeve at first, or just inside here. He's probably gonna reach to control my leg so he can begin his guard passing. Great, that's where I'm gonna grip this sleeve. If it's a grip on my pants or even just a strong grip on the ankle, I'm gonna pull the sleeve to me and kick out to strip it. I'm gonna bring my foot back in and I'm gonna kick just above his knee, not up into where his front pocket would be and not directly at it, just an inch or two above. As I kick that out, I'm gonna keep my foot stuck to his thigh and I sit up, dropping my De La Riva hook. I release his leg and I start to hug the front leg here. I pass two hands onto the same side sleeve. Now, I've seen a lot of people come up and reach way over on the yoke to pull him over, but I know he's not gonna stay here. He's gonna begin to posture. So he starts posturing up. I'm gonna just slide the initial sleeve grip here up to his collar, and I wanna try to get my thumb by his jawbone. From here, I kick his leg, I pull this, and even if he's basing really hard, one of the things I like to do is focus on the sleeve grip I've got now and pulling it behind his leg to help break his posture. Then I don't need the yoke grip. So as I kick and I fall to my side, I pull and I dump him down. Pulling the sleeve up over his thigh, trying to connect my hands as I come up and switch my base to copy his hip. I'm basically at a really big knee slide position now. You can circle this way. And what I'm gonna look to do is release his sleeve and make an underhook. My ear is gonna go next to his ear on the same side as my collar grip here. And I knee slide over both of his legs. Now I walk backwards to kill his hips. I circle and make my cross face, pull him into me, doorstop his hip, two steps to his head. All right, so we're De La Riva Guard. I have a good hook, knee to knee, foot way up high into the groin and the inner thigh. My leg is either tight to me or it's up here. If he's already grabbing it, he's probably gonna wanna try to put it in between his legs to step over it. So it's very important that I pull my knee back to my chest so I can reach this sleeve grip. Break the grip if you need. I'm gonna kick and sit up at the same time. I drop my De La Riva hook and I pass the two on one. I'm gonna release my first sleeve grip, climb up to the collar. I'm gonna kick and pull, focusing on pulling the sleeve grip I've got now behind his knee. And when we come up, I'm gonna try to wrap it over his thigh. This is really tight and really uncomfortable. He's not gonna hip escape. He's not gonna recover his guard. I sit on his hip. I release the sleeve and make my underhook, head to the mat. Knee slide out. Walk backwards to kill the hip, cross face, pull him in, doorstop to replace the coverage my knee had on his hip, and then we're inside here.